Rediscovering Advent, preparing our hearts for Christmas. This is week two. In our first installment of Rediscovering Advent, we looked at how the prophecy of Isaiah not only talks about the hope of the Messiah, but the very fact that prophecy exists at all is evidence of the plan of God in all things. And this should mean hope for us. In week two, today of Advent, we want to take a look at Isaiah chapter 40 and what it means to prepare the way for the Savior. This is how verses 3 to 5 goes. A voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain and hill made low. The rough ground shall become level, the rugged places a plain. And the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all people will see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. So the idea here of preparing the way comes from the ancient kings. You know, they were preparing to go maybe to a new territory, to another country, and they would send people before them to prepare the way. Literally, they were like surveyors or scouts who went before to figure out which was the best way to get through some forest or some to get over rivers or some difficult spots. They would mark the way through, and they would improve the route even to make sure that it was safe for the king. So they could be called forerunners or pioneers, the ones sent before a king to prepare the way. You know, I remember when we first visited Yukon, my parents used to live there, so we had opportunity to visit a few times. And, well, Yukon, in that little piece of Alaska that cuts across our territory along the coast of the Pacific to Juneau and Skagway, if you know. In that area, at the turn of the 20th century, the Klondike Gold Rush, often called the Yukon Gold Rush, was a mass exodus of prospecting migrants, mostly Americans, from their hometowns to Canadian Yukon territory. Of course, they were looking for gold that was, they were told, discovered there in 1896. The idea of striking it rich led over 100,000 people from all walks of life to abandon their homes and embark on an extended, life-threatening journey across treacherous, icy valleys and harrowing, rocky terrain. And believe me, I've seen this terrain myself, and it is rough terrain. You realize that less than half of those who started the trek to Yukon actually arrived there. We're talking 50,000 people didn't make it. And those who did get to places like Dawson City safely stood little chance of finding gold at all. It's an amazing story. Do you realize that in this story, there were also forerunners, scouts, George Carmack, Jim Mason, Dawson Charlie. I mean, even their names sound kind of tough, right? These were men who were the first to brave the impossible terrain and the weather, and to finally discover a prize that really they didn't even know existed at first. Gold, of course. It's the news that they brought back with them that really fired the imaginations of thousands to follow the same trail that the forerunners had gone on. So places like Klondike River, Rabbit Creek, Chilkoot Trail, White Pass Trail, these are all names that, were household names because of these people who went on before and prepared the way. So in the case of Jesus, John the Baptist was the one crying in the wilderness. He was the one preparing the way for the Son of God. John reminded the people about what it meant to repent and turn from their wicked ways. He used the illustration of being baptized in water, allowing the light of the truth of God to get into every part of you and to purify you. John the Baptist dressed as one who lived a life of humility before God, a rethinking priorities in the light of God's holiness. All of this, it's kind of like hearing about Chilkoot Trail for the first time, right? And the people are reminded of all this through John the Baptist. So these are all principles and illustrations that would be made alive by the coming of Jesus. John was fueling the imagination and building faith. Jesus would be the validation of that faith, the glory of the Lord, or if you will, the gold, right? Each of us in our daily lives, we interact with family, co-workers, neighbors, and others who may know very little or nothing of God and His Word. Our words and our deeds could well pave the way for them to eventually answer God's call at another time. Each of us has opportunities to set an example that will affect their lives, hopefully in a positive way. In this way, each of us is a forerunner, marking and improving the trail through the conduct or the way that we live our lives. And so you can be Dawson Charlie today. You can be a John the Baptist in someone's life. Let me read you the words of a famous Christmas hymn. O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel that mourns in lonely exile here until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou dayspring, come and cheer our spirits by thine advent here. Disperse the gloomy clouds of night and death's dark shadow put to flight. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Why not let's use this Christmas season to be a voice crying out in the wilderness of people's hearts, and maybe we can bring them closer to finding gold, to finding the glory of God in their lives. Lord bless you today.